Now you've heard the story of that other Lincoln, a big bag of wind, that's what I've been thinking. It was nothing but a car with a Lincoln body, the rest of the works was kinda shoddy. How do I know? Well, I can boast, I was that guy as white as a ghost. Oh, it would go and go like mad, but the inner workings were terrible sad. The frame was sprung, the shaft had a crack, man, that thing should have been in a sack. The rods was bent and the radiator leaked, the wheels grunted, groaned, and squeaked. As we wheezed down the highway that fateful night, all we saw was that little light that shows on the dashboard all red aglow that the oil pressure was mighty low. Our exhaust pipe was thrown out a big smoke screen and the smell of it was making me green. I turned to my seat and I looked out the back and that's when I saw that big Cadillac. It was long and low and something was weird. The guy behind the wheel had a strange looking beard. He looked at us and we looked at him. We knew our chances were pretty slim. But he got on it and so did we, and we started tearing up Highway 63. Flying low and flying wide, we kept that Cadillac right by our side. I looked at the tack, it was winding 6 grand. I knew it was here, we had to make our stand. But the weird beard there didn't make no mind. He just let that critter unwind. The flames from his bluey pipes were turning red. Man, I should have stayed in bed. When we went around a corner, I started to freeze. The pressure on me was pulling 30 G's. His wire wheels whistled as they went around. If we went any faster, we'd leave the ground. Side by side, like a flying wedge, neither one of us giving an edge. Then all of a sudden, I heard a cry from beneath the beard of that weird-looking guy. He said, "Pull over, I've got something to say." So we shut down the race and called it a day. But here's where the story bogs a bit, and I'm still not sure if I believe it. He said a piston was gone, and he had a cracked rotor, and he'd been going all along on his starter motor.